So I wrote down here the main takeaway from chapter one, and I'll try to do this going forward in the semester. Essentially, the list of formulas that you should know, and you will find that this list is actually very, very short. So for example, you won't find Malus's law here, you won't find the formula for critical angle here, you won't find the formula for polarizing angle of incidence. It's consistent with the approach in physics. You want as many problems as possible, you want to be able to solve it from first principles. So Malus's law, you don't need it, because if you understand the whole polarization thing is about taking projection of electric field vector, then you can drive it on the spot. You don't need the critical angle for total internal reflection, because if you have Snell's law, you remember the condition. That condition is that on the outgoing side, the angle is 90 degrees. And the similar thing for the polarizing angle, or Brewster's angle. You remember the relationship between angles. So the formulas that I prefer to memorize are the ones that I cannot drive on the spot quickly. I mean, I guess these are kind of more of a definition, so I just write them down. Snell's law is the one that I would memorize. Because if you are trying to derive Snell's law from scratch, that takes a little bit too long, and you don't want to be doing that for every problem. So these are some of these formulas are what we'll use today as we go through the practical geometric optics.